This screencast shows the user experience of integrating third-party authentication with Rotten Potatoes. We're going to allow users to log into Rotten Potatoes with an existing Twitter account, but because we're using the OmniAuth gem, we could just as easily have allowed users to log in with almost any third-party authentication out there, including Facebook, MSN, Amazon, and so forth. The first visible difference is we've added a new link, log in with your Twitter account. And if you look at the bottom window in the browser here, you can see when I hover over the link that its target is /auth/Twitter. Now, that isn't a real URL in our application. We don't have a route for it. But the OmniAuth gem arranges to redirect that URL to the real Twitter site where we would authenticate whether we want to allow the app access to our Twitter information. Let's follow the link and see what happens. Notice, first of all, that I'm now on Twitter's actual site, and I'm on a secure connection, so nothing I type is going to be visible to Rotten Potatoes. Twitter, like several other third-party authentication sites, uses the OAuth protocol as the way of doing authentication, not to be confused with OmniAuth, the name of the gem that we're using. In the OAuth protocol, when an application wants access to information about you from a third-party auth provider like Twitter, the app needs to state its name. In this case, Rotten Potatoes is calling itself SASBook Test. And it needs to specify what information about you or what capabilities on your account it's asking for. In this case, Rotten Potatoes is going to be able to read tweets from my timeline and see who I follow, but it will not be able to do any of these things on my behalf using my Twitter account. It's good practice to limit what you ask for because users might be hesitant to give your app arbitrary privileges on their account, especially in cases like Twitter and Facebook, which are highly visible. At this point, we've got two options. One possibility is I can decide as a Twitter user that I don't want to allow the app access to any of this information. If I do this, suppose I click cancel and return to app, I set up a very simple controller method to handle the failure case. The only thing it does is print out what the parameters to the controller method would have been, and you can see that the only meaningful information we're getting is invalid credentials. That means Rotten Potatoes asked for permission to behave as me in some way from Twitter, but I denied that permission. Of course, in a real application, we'd have a much nicer view of this information and a helpful message to the user asking why they didn't allow our app to use their authentication information. Suppose, on the other hand, that we go through the flow and we decide to allow the app access to this information after all. We'll go back and click on the login with your Twitter account, and this time, when I'm taken to the Twitter page, I'll enter my username and password, and I'll click sign in. What's going to happen at this point is the sign in is actually going to be posted to Twitter directly, and once Twitter is satisfied that I've typed my correct password, it will redirect back to Rotten Potatoes with a token containing the information that the application asked for, redirecting you back to the application. And sure enough, Rotten Potatoes now recognizes me as a Twitter user. The reason Rotten Potatoes knows my name is because when Rotten Potatoes asked for access via Twitter, my name and basic information is one of the things that it asked for. So this piece of information is actually coming straight from Twitter. It's important that there is really two distinct concepts of identity here, and this is something that you'll have to get used to as the world moves more and more towards third-party authentication. On the one hand, the Rotten Potatoes app has a table of moviegoers. Each moviegoer has a unique ID, just like we do for any other active record model. But the authentication, in other words, who vouches for the fact that a moviegoer has a particular identity, is really being provided by the external provider, in this case, Twitter. In our really simple example for this chapter, we just added fields for the provider name, Twitter, and the provider UID, in other words, the unique number Twitter assigns me as a user, and the Rotten Potatoes moviegoer model is augmented with those fields. A more sophisticated approach would be to create a separate table for external identities. For example, it might have a record for me as a Twitter user or me as a Facebook user, and establishing a has-many relationship from moviegoers to the identities table. That would allow me to link multiple accounts, say Twitter, Facebook, and MSN, all at the same time to my single Rotten Potatoes account. So that's a simple example and walkthrough of how third-party authentication is easier to do than doing your own password authentication and allows users to take advantage of existing applications and social networks that they have.